Okay, in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to add a lens flare to an image. Normally with a lens flare you're either trying to get rid of the lens flare within a photograph or use that lens flare as an accentuating point to make the image a little bit more interesting, engaging. For this example here it's the latter. So the first thing you want to do is once you have your image chosen, we're going to create a new layer. So we can go to the bottom of the layers dialog panel, click on the icon of a page to create a new layer. It is a clear layer. You want to fill this with black, so we'll go to the edit menu, go to fill, and choose black. And that image is completely filled with black. We're unable to see anything, so what we're going to need to do is create a blend mode for this layer to show it through. So we'll go to the layers menu here to normal, select screen. Screen lightens the actual image so we can actually see the image shown through. From here, we're then going to use a filter called lens flare. So we'll go to the filters menu, select render, then lens flare. Lens flare options dialog box gives you several options. You have a 50 to 30 millimeter zoom, you have a 35 millimeter prime, 105, and then movie prime. And each of these have some interesting effects to that. I think probably the most interesting one for this example would probably be the 50 to 300 millimeter zoom. You can increase or decrease the brightness, as you can see that you can have it very shallow or quite intense. For this purpose, you could probably have it a little bit more brighter than you anticipate, and you could always tone it down later. Once that's selected, just simply click OK, and voila, you have your lens flare. Now you have a couple options to make adjustments to this. First thing you want to do is select a free transform. So we'll go to the edit menu, go to free transform. This will create a selection dialog box here. We can then increase or decrease the size of this effect taking place. We can then move this across. We can also rotate the direction of where that lens flare you want to have it go. For this purpose, I think we'll probably keep it in its original position. Maybe have this just off of center, maybe right between these people right here. Maybe increase the size a little bit more with that selection there. Maybe drag it right in between these two people. That would be kind of interesting in that location there. After that is selected, just simply hit the enter or return key. Now that we've made that selection, you can actually see that the effect here is showing off of the edge. So what we'll need to do is create a layer mask. So we'll go down to the bottom of the layers panel, select the layer mask option. It's created a new layer mask. Make sure that you select the layer mask. Go to your swatches panel in your toolbox. Make sure that black is the top tool. So we can use the back and forth arrow key here so that black is on top. Select your paintbrush. And once your paintbrush is selected, you can use the drop-down menu. Make sure that the hardness is at 0%. You can increase and decrease the size of your paintbrush. Make sure it's a relatively large size. Make sure that your mode is at normal here, opacity at 100%. And then from here, you can just simply slowly erase on the edges so that you're starting to burn in a nice soft transition zone of this effect that's taking place. And we have a nice rounded edge effect that is coming in. So it looks kind of nice. Next step is if the lens flare is a little bit too intense, we can then go to the opacity and reduce the intensity of that lens flare. So we're gonna kind of bring that down maybe close to 70%. So somewhere around there, that looks good. Click on the visibility of before and after. So before we have a interesting silhouette image, afterwards a quick shiny lens flare that's coming out from below. So adding a lens flare to your image.